Assalamu alaikum students, my name is Dr. Ikra. Today the practical we will be performing is determination of WBC count by Newport chamber. You have already discussed Newport chamber or hemocytometer in your previous practical, and today we will continue the use of that hemocytometer to determine the count of WBCs in the blood. First of all, a little introduction about WBCs or white blood cells. As you already know, WBCs are also called as leukocytes. They are colorless nucleated cells that are circulating in the blood. The function of WBCs is that they defend the body against foreign particles. Those foreign particles may be bacteria, viruses, or any invading organism in the body. The principle of this practical or the determination of WBC count by Newport chamber is that the blood is first diluted with a suitable fluid which destroys the RBCs and the cell wall of WBCs and stains the nuclei of WBCs. The purpose of this dilution is that, first of all, if we start counting the WBCs in the undiluted blood in the Newport chamber, the cells will be so much in number that it will be impossible to count them. The second purpose is the suitable fluid, the diluting fluid, destroys the RBCs so they don't interfere in the count of WBCs. When the cell walls of WBCs are destroyed, the nuclei of WBCs get stained, which makes the identification of WBCs easier. After that, the leukocytes are counted in the hemocytometer and their number is calculated in undiluted blood. So that is the principle of this practical, which is the determination of WBC count by Newport chamber. Moving on, we will discuss the apparatus which will be used in this practical. The first apparatus is hemocytometer itself. Hemocytometer consists of three things or three parts. First is the Newport chamber, which we will discuss in detail afterwards. Second thing is the WBC pipette. And the third thing is the cover slip. We will also need a microscope. We will need all the apparatus which is used to take a blood sample, which is a sterile lancet or a pricking needle. We will also need a spirit swab or an alcohol swab, and we will need a watch glass. The reagents will be used in WBC count is Turk's fluid. The composition of Turk's fluid is, it is composed of glacial acetic acid, which is 1.5 ml in the Turk's fluid. The function of glacial acetic acid is that it hemolyzes the RBCs and cell wall of WBCs. The other thing in Turk's fluid is 1% Jenkin Boiler solution in water, which is 1 ml in the Turk's fluid. The purpose of Jenkin Boiler solution in the Turk's fluid is that it stains the nuclei of leukocytes, which make their identification easy. And the last thing is distilled water, which is 100 ml in the Turk's fluid. The Turk's fluid is already made. You don't have to make it by mixing these drinks, but you have to remember the composition of Turk's fluid used in the determination of WBC count by the Newport chamber. Okay students, now we will discuss the apparatus which will be used in this practical or the WBC count by the Newport chamber. The first things which we will need are all the things which are required to take a blood sample from a subject under a sterile condition. The first thing needed is a spirit swab. The second thing needed for that is a sterile lancet or a pricking needle. Make sure that the pricking needle you are using is sterile and covered. Okay, the next thing which is used for the WBC count is the hemocytometer, which has three parts. The first part is the Newport chamber. Right here, you can see. This is the central area of the Newport chamber, which will be charged later. And we will do the counting under the microscope in this central area. The next thing used is the WBC pipette. This is the WBC pipette. The identification of WBC pipette from the RBC pipette is that the bulb of the RBC pipette has a red bead inside it,
whereas the WBC pipette has a white bead inside its bulb. So this is the WBC pipette. You can also see the markings on the WBC pipette. The first mark on the WBC pipette is at 0.5 and the second mark is at 0.11. The next thing used is the cover slip. This is the watch glass. The purpose of the watch glass is that the Turk's fluid is taken in the watch glass and then it is taken into the pipette. This is the reagent, the Turk's fluid, which will be used in this practical. It is a purplish colored fluid. It is already made. You don't have to mix it yourself. You have to make sure that it is the WBC fluid. It will be marked as or labeled as WBC fluid or as Turk's fluid. And the last thing needed is a functioning microscope. So this is the apparatus which will be used in this practical. Okay students, starting with the procedure of this practical, the first step is that we take the Turk's fluid in the watch glass. It is roughly taken about 3 to 5 ml in the watch glass. This will make it easier for it to be later taken into the WBC pipette if it is in a watch glass. Okay student, the next step in the practical is that we have to take a blood sample from a healthy, comfortable subject. For that you have to take his consent. In any case, in any setting where you have to perform a procedure on a subject, you have to first take his or her consent. First of all, the protocol of this consent taking is that I will introduce myself to him. I will explain all the procedure to him and then I will take his consent. Make sure that the subject is seated comfortably in a comfortable setting. So first of all, I will take his consent. Assalamu alaikum. Mera naam Dr. Ikra hai. Maine aaj ek practical karne ke liye mujhe kuch khoon chahiye jo ke main aapki ungli se lungi. इसके लिए मुझे आपको एक नीडल की मदद से जो है वो थोड़ा सा प्रिक करके खून लेना पड़ेगा, उसमें आपको थोड़ी सी तकलीफ़ होगी, तो इसके लिए आप मुझे इजाज़त देते हैं? ओके, सो नाउ वी विल टेक द सैम्पल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, एनी फिंगर ऑफ हिज हैंड विल बी क्लीन्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ स्पिरिट स्वैब, देन इट विल बी लेट टू ड्राई फॉर अ कपल ऑफ मिनट्स. आफ्टर दैट, with the help of a sterile pricking needle, his needle will be gently pricked. Make sure to wipe off the first drop of blood. Then the finger will be squeezed a little to make a drop of blood stand out on the finger. This drop of blood will then be sucked into the WBC pipette up to the 0.05. After that, the tip of the WBC pipette will be cleaned with the help of a clean cotton swab. After this, we will take the Turk's fluid in the WBC pipette up to the point mark 11. This is taken out of the watch glass in which we already placed it. The next step is that you have to mix the blood and the fluid inside the WBC pipette by moving it inside your palms like that for about a minute. This will ensure proper mixing of the blood with the Turk's fluid inside the bulb of the WBC pipette. Okay, the next step is that we have to charge the Neuber chamber. For that we have to first take a clean cover slip and place it over the central area of the Neuber chamber as shown in the video. After that, we will take the WBC pipette in which the blood and the Turk's fluid is already mixed. We will discard first 1 to 2 drops of that mixture. And then we will charge the Neuber chamber by making contact of the WBC pipette with the cover slip at an angle of 45 degrees and letting a small drop of the mixture seep under the cover slip. So this is the charging of the Neuber chamber. We will wait for about 4 to 5 minutes for the cells to settle down. Okay, the last step in the practical is that we have to
adjust the charred Newbert chamber under the microscope like this. Now this Newbert chamber will be focused under 10x lens, and the central area of the Newbert chamber will be focused. After that, you will count the cell in the Newbert chamber, which I will explain now. So this is the last step in the practical. Okay students, after you have focused the Newbert chamber under 10x lens under the microscope, we will start counting the leukocytes. I will explain in detail how the leukocytes are counted in the Newbert chamber. First, we will see in which boxes of the Newbert chamber the leukocytes are counted. This is a Newbert chamber. You have already been introduced to it in the introduction to hemocytometer practical. So you can see that the central area of the Newbert chamber is for RBC count, and for WBC count, the boxes of the Newbert chamber which are used are the four corner boxes, where the capital W is written. So in the four corner boxes, the WBCs are counted under the microscope. The rule of counting is the Thomas rule of counting. WBCs are counted in the four corner squares. Each big square is divided into 16 smaller squares. You can see that each big corner square is further subdivided into 16 smaller squares. You can call these smaller squares a small square or a medium square. It doesn't matter. But you have to remember that the four corner boxes are further subdivided into 16 smaller or medium squares. So the total number of squares are 64, as 4 into 16 is 64. So cells are counted in an inverted L shape, leave lower left manner. Like if you are counting in the chamber, you will leave the lower left of the big corner. So in this picture, you can see that one side of one big square is 1 millimeter in the Newbert chamber. Now I will show you how an uncharred Newbert chamber will appear under the microscope, as there is no way of showing with the help of a camera. This is how an uncharred Newbert chamber will appear under the microscope if you focus it. And after charging it with the mixture of the Turk's fluid and the blood, this is how the Newbert chamber will appear. You can see that the cells are seen as small, rounded, dark dots. So this is how the WBCs will appear under the microscope in a Newbert chamber. You will first have to locate and focus the four corner boxes, and then you will start counting the WBCs in an inverted L manner in the four corner boxes. This is another picture of how WBCs appear under the microscope. Now we will discuss the calculations for the TLC or the WBC count, which will help us to determine the total WBC count in the blood. So now first of all, we have to calculate the dilution factor. We have diluted the blood with the help of a Turk's fluid. So we will first calculate the dilution factor. You know that we took the blood in the WBC pipette up to the 0.5, and then we took the Turk's fluid up to the part up to the mark 11. So you can say that 0.5 part of blood is diluted in 10 parts of fluid, or 9.5 parts of the diluting fluid. The fluid present in the stem does not take part in the mixing. So the dilution factor is calculated as total volume of bulb, which is 10 parts, divided by the volume of blood taken, which is 0.5 parts. So if you divide 10 by 0.5, you will get a dilution factor of 20. Now we know that the number of medium or smaller squares in the four corner square is 64. We have calculated the WBCs in those four corner squares, and we assign it a value of X. That is, the total number of WBCs counted in 64 medium square is X. You can say the total number of WBCs counted in one medium square will then be X by 64. Okay, students, you know that the side of one medium square is 1/4 of a millimeter because the side of one big corner square is 1 millimeter. That one big corner square, when divided into 4 smaller squares on each side, will give a side of one medium square as 1/4 of a millimeter. The area of that one medium square can be calculated as length into width of the medium square. We know that the length and width of the medium square both is 1/4 of a millimeter. So if we multiply 1/4 into 1/4, we get an area of 1/16 millimeter square. So the area of one medium square is 1/16 millimeter square. Moving on, we know that the depth of the newborn chamber is 1/10 millimeter. This is constant, that is the depth of the newborn chamber as it is made. So we can, with the help of this depth, we can calculate the volume of one medium square as area into depth of the square. So the volume of the square will be 1/16, which is the area of the square, into 1/10. So the volume of the one square will be 1/60 millimeter cube. So now we see that if the number of WBCs in 64 medium square is X, which we have counted with the help of a microscope and by using the Thomas rule of counting, then we can also say that the number of WBCs in one medium square is X/64. We already know that the volume of one medium square is 1/60 millimeter cube. So the number of WBCs in one medium square will also be equal to the number of WBCs in 1/60 millimeter cube, because that is the volume of that one medium square. So in 1/60 millimeter cube, the number of WBCs will be X/64. In 1 millimeter cube, the number of WBCs will be X/64 into 160, or 10x/4. Now we know that the dilution factor is 20, as we have already calculated in the start. So in the end, we can conclude that the undiluted blood contains total number of WBCs as 10x/4 into 20, or 50x/mm³. So you have to calculate the WBCs in the newborn chamber, and by using these calculations, in the end you will get the number of WBCs in 1 mm³ of undiluted blood. I hope you understood the practical, and that is all for the calculation of WBC count by newborn chamber. Thank you very much.